Ok, qué bueno. Entonces, hoy vamos a empezar con eso. Mi papi tiene un moto. My papi has a motorcycle. Do you guys know this book? No? All right. Excellent. I love all these new books we're reading. All right. Entonces, mi papi tiene un moto. Vamos a empezar. Mi papi tiene una moto. De él he aprendido palabras como carburador y cariño, taladro y dedicación. My papi has a motorcycle. From him, I've learned words like carburetor and cariño, drill and dedication. Cuando oigo que su camioneta gris se acerca a la entrada de nuestra casa, salgo corriendo con nuestros cascos. When I hear his gray truck pull into our driveway, I run outside with both our helmets. Mi papi, que es un carpintero, está cubierto de aserrín y huele a un día de mucho trabajo. Sus manos están rugosas de estar construyendo casas todos los días. Su trabajo desde que llegó a este país. Pero aunque llega a casa cansado, siempre tiene tiempo para mí. My papi the carpenter is covered in sawdust and smells like a hard day at work. His hands are rough from building homes every day, his job since he first arrived in this country. But even though he comes home tired, he always has time for me. Al final del día, me lleva a dar una vuelta. Hoy me va a mostrar una de las casas nuevas que está construyendo. Papi tiene cuidado que no jalarme el cabello mientras me pone el casco. Cuando me levanta para sentarme en la silla negra y suave, sus manos no se sienten rugosas, no se sienten cansadas, se sienten como todo el amor que se le hace difícil decir con palabras. ¿Lista? Sí. When our city is winding down, he takes me for a ride. Today, he's going to show me the new houses he's working on. Papi is careful with my ponytail as he pulls my helmet tight. When he lifts me onto the smooth black seat, his hands don't feel rough. They don't feel tired. They feel like all the love he has trouble saying. Lista? Ready? Yes. Papi enciende el motor y el olor de a gasolina me pega en el momento en que aprieta el acelerador. Con cuidado, be careful. Papi revs the engine and the smell of gasoline hits me as he squeezes the accelerator. Con cuidado, be careful. El motor retumba y gruñe. The motor rumbles and growls. Agárrate, hold on. Y arrancamos. And then we take off. Who do you think, if this is her papi, who do you think these people might be? ¿Quién son esas personas? Andrea?
I think they're like somebody don't have a house in their bill. They're making one for the doll of the boy, and they really want like a house like that. So I think he's building that house. And they said, be careful, don't knock our house. I think that's why.
What do you think, Malachi?
Well, I think that there are people across the street, like they live there. They have a house there, and they're probably just out to smell the fresh air. So they spot them and say, be careful, be careful.
Maybe. I think those are both good ideas. My idea, because this is her house, right? Maybe this is her mom. And maybe someone else in her family. I don't know. But they could all be the right ideas. Maybe we'll find out later. Let's see. Maybe they won't tell us. Maybe we just have to guess. El metal azul brillante de la moto brilla en el cielo. El sol naranja radiante se está acostando y el cielo se vuelve azul y morado y dorado. Nos convertimos en algo celestial y espectacular volando sobre el asfalto. Una cometa, el aserrín que cae del pelo y la ropa de papi se transforma en una cola que se extiende detrás nuestro. The shiny blue metal of the motorcycle glows in the sun. The sun, the bright orange sun is on its way down, turning our sky blue and purple and gold. We become a spectacular celestial thing soaring on asphalt. A comet, the sawdust fading, falling from Poppy's hair, and clothes becoming a tail, following us. Poppy zigzagué por las calles. Pasamos la iglesia de abuelita y la tortillería de Estrella, y paramos cuando se nos cruzan los gatos cajeros. Mami piensa que hay demasiados, pero a mí me parece que apenas hay suficientes. Oh, that was a little low. Sorry, guys. Papi zigzags through the streets. We pass Abuelita's church and Tortillería de la Estrella and stop for stray cats crossing in front of us. Mommy thinks there's too many of them, but I think there's just enough. Right, so the church and the tortilleria. Malachi, is your hand still raised from before, or do you have something else you wanted to say?
Oh, yes, it's raised from before. My bad.
No worries. Just wanted to make sure you didn't have something you needed to share. Pasamos Joy's Market, donde mami me compra ositos de goma. Señor García, el bibliotecario, está saliendo por la puerta y nos saluda con la cabeza. Nosotros hacemos lo mismo. Así es como siempre nos saludamos. We pass Joy's Market where mommy buys me gummy bears. Mr. Garcia, our librarian, is walking out the door and nods at us. We nod back. This is how we always greet each other. What other things do you see that they sell at the market? ¿Qué otras cosas pueden ver que ellos se venden aquí? Andrea?
Well, I think I can see like some flags there and gummy bears, but I can see like something, and also I can see like a car and like something to the shop, and I can see something inside that looks like popcorn.
Oh, maybe popcorn, yeah, for sure. Malachi?
Well, I wanted to say that due to the building, it looks like that they produce milk. I mean, meat.
Oh, meat.
Due to the sign.
Oh, yeah. They have meat. You're right. They have meat, produce, and bread.
Yep. And if you look beside the sign, you can see there's piñatas.
Mm-hmm. They have piñatas, you're right. So they sell all sorts of things. Rugiendo, pasamos frente a murales que cuentan nuestra historia. Una historia de cultivos de cítricos y los inmigrantes que los trabajaron. Y de la famosa carrera de carros que sucedió en el Gran Boulevard hace 100 años. Ahora sé que vamos a parar en la tienda de raspados de Don Rudy.
We roar past murals that tell our history of citrus groves and immigrants who worked them, and of the famous road race that took place on Grand Boulevard 100 years ago. Now I know that we're stopping at Don Rudy's raspados.
Pero a medida que nos acercamos a la tienda, vemos que está vacía y que ha cerrado. Notó que papi está decepcionado.
But as we near the shop, we see that it's empty and out of business.
Oh no.
I can tell papi is disappointed.
Imaginó el olor de los dulces jarabes que Don Rudy le echa a sus raspados. No seré la única que lo eche de menos.
I imagine the smell of the sweet syrups Don Rudy uses to flavor our shaved ice. I won't be the only one who misses him.
Oh no.
Seguimos adelante y sintió y oigo a todos y todo lo que pasamos. Cada sonido llega a mis oídos y reconstruye todo el barrio dentro de mí. No importa que tan lejos me vaya de este lugar, o cuanto cambie, esta ciudad siempre estará conmigo.
As we ride on, I feel and hear everyone and everything we pass by. Each sound landing on my ears rebuilds whole neighborhoods inside me. No matter how far I go from this place or how much it changes, this city will always be in me. What are some of the things they're passing? ¿Qué son algunas de las cosas que ellos están pasando? Andrea?
Well, I can see like a unicorn like cowbell. I can see like the children and the bicycle. I see like a man have like ice cream inside, and I can see like a girl and a boy playing soccer and letters and a letters and a man doing stuff and I can see like some more letters.
Okay. Malachi, what do you see? Right? We have our two people playing soccer. A bicycle selling ice cream. What's one more thing that you see?
Well, what I see is I can see that someone is mowing the lawn because I can see that for the onomatopoeia. Mm-hmm. And I can also see that there are birds in the trees because there's chirp, chirp, chirp.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's so right. They're using a lot of onomatopoeia here on this page, right? They're talking about all these different sounds of the neighborhood that we mentioned. Awesome.
Pasamos por la vieja casa María de abuelito y abuelita, la que tiene el limonero que creció de la semilla de los limones de abuelito antes recogía no muy lejos de aquí. Mami dice que vamos a visitarlos mañana para recoger
nopales y comer albóndigas hechas en la cocina de la abuelita, donde la comida siempre sabe mejor. Dobla. Oh. Mija, adiós, mi reina. Adiós. We cruise by abuelito and abuelita's yellow, old yellow house. The one with the lemon tree that grew from the seeds that, of the lemons abuelito used to pick not far from here. Mommy says we're going to visit them tomorrow to cut nopales from their garden and eat herby albóndigas in abuela's kitchen, where the food always tastes better. Doblamos la esquina y we turn the corner and then... Los perros detrás de las cercas se vuelven locos. The dogs behind the fences go wild. Frankie, el labrador de los López, se escapa del jardín y nos persigue corriendo. Mercedes López, la corredora más veloz de nuestra clase, corre detrás de él. Frankie, the López's labradoodle, escapes from her yard and runs after us. Mercedes López, the fastest runner in our class, races after her. Entonces, tan rápido como aparecieron los perros que ladran y Mercedes y Frankie se convierten en un suave murmullo en la distancia. Then, just as fast as the dogs barking and Mercedes and Frankie become a soft hush in the distance. Están justo detrás de nosotros. They're right behind us. But they're so fast that soon they're far behind. Vamos hasta las casas nuevas que ahora se alzan donde antes estaban los últimos cultivos de cítricos. Los pintores, los albañiles y los que ponen el piso nos saludan, pero casi no escuchamos sus palabras entre el ruido de los martillos y los compresores de aire. We ride towards the new homes, replacing the last of the citrus groves. The painters, drywallers, and floor layers all greet us, but we can barely hear the words amid the sounds of hammers and air compressors. ¿Trabajando duro, muchachos? Un poco, no demasiado. A little, not too much. Pero incluso con todo ese ruido, la voz de mi papi toca todo. Even in all that noise, my papi's voice touches everything. How does it look like they feel? ¿Cómo se sienten ellos? Malachi?
I think that they feel happy. And yeah.
Yeah, awesome. Agarra el círculo, around the circle. Esta es mi parte preferida. This is my favorite part. En Gran Boulevard nos inclinamos en dirección de la curva. Imagino que estamos en una de esas carreras que tuvieron lugar aquí hace tantos años. Es nuestra última vuelta y tenemos que ganar. El público nos anima con sus gritos. Siento la sonrisa de papi mientras lo abrazo más fuerte. On Grand Boulevard, we lean into the curve of the street. I make believe that we're on one of the races that took place here so long ago. It's our last lap and we have to win. The crowd cheers us on. I feel Papi smile as I squeeze my arms tight around him. Vamos, papi, más rápido, más rápido. Faster, faster. Volamos alrededor del círculo. Ahí está la escuela donde entramos fútbol. Ahí está la oficina de correos donde señor Charlie recibe nuestras cartas. Y ahí está la panadería donde papi compra conchas los sábados en la mañana. We fly around the circle. There's the school where we practice soccer. There's the post office where Mr. Charlie takes our letters. And la panadería where papi buys conchas on Sunday mornings. Vroom. Aquí está toda nuestra hermosa ciudad. Mis ojos intentan absorberlo todo, pero los colores de las casas se mezclan los unos con los otros. Rojo, azul, verde, anaranjado, rosa. Here it is, all of our beautiful city. My eyes try to catch everything, but the colors of houses blend one into the other. Red, blue, green, orange, pink. Avanzamos, avanzamos, avanzamos hasta que el brillo azul de la moto empieza a disminuir y nuestra cola de cometa se ha quedado en las calles que hemos transitado. Emprendemos el camino de regreso a casa y poco a poco el motor nos lleva a nuestra calle y a la entrada de nuestra casa, nuestra meta. Mami y hermanito oyen la moto y salen corriendo a saludarnos. Igual que un árbitro, mami nos hace señas para que entremos. Papi y yo no podemos parar de reírnos. Le hacemos pasado bien. We ride, ride, ride until the blue glow of the motorcycle begins to dim and our comet tail has been left behind on the streets we've traveled. We head home and slowly the engine echoes us back onto our street and then our driveway, our finish line. Mommy and little brother hear the motorcycle and run out to greet us. Mommy waves us in just like a referee. Papi and I can't stop laughing. We had a good ride. So who were those people? ¿Quién estaba esas personas? Andrea?
I know. That's the brother and the mother.
Mm-hmm. So that was the brother and the mom before saying goodbye.
I thought one thing, when the second part began, I saw the both ponytails, one here and one in the back.
Mm-hmm. Right, her and her mom both wear ponytails. So
and also the dad have like the hair as the brother have.
Oh, they have a similar haircut? Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's some good observing. En medio de nuestras risas, escucho un sonido que se me hace conocido. Through our laughter, I hear a familiar sound. Honk, honk, raspados. Pienso en mi ciudad y en todos los cambios por lo que ha pasado y en todos los cambios que vendrán. I think about my city and all the changes that it's been through and all the changes that will come. Chicle y fresa, por favor. So, who do we think this is? Do we remember his name? Malachi?
I think that he is the ice cream man.
Mm-hmm. Don Rudy, right?
Don Rudy.
At a store that was closed, but now he has a cart. So he didn't totally go away. Right? It just changed. Solo cambia. Pero sé que aquí en nuestra casita hay cosas que siempre se mantendrán igual. Mañana volamos de nuevo.
But I know that here in our little house, there are things that will always stay the same. Mañana we fly again. What's she saying? She thinks she knows will always stay the same. Malachi?
I think that she knows that her dad will always be there for her.
Yeah, I think you're right. Awesome, my friends. What'd you think of that book? You liked it? Awesome. Yo también. I liked it too. We're going to do one more book today. Let me just do this part. Hold on. Oh, because I read this book with my kiddos. I got to move it back. All right. This book is called De Donde Eres? Where are you from? Have you guys read this book? ¿Ha leído eso? No? Awesome. All right. This book has some really pretty pictures. So I'm going to make sure to show you all of them. The sun rising in the morning, coming up over the mountains. Her and all these pictures of her family. Los fotos de la familia. ¿De dónde eres? Preguntan. Where are you from? They ask. ¿Tu mamá es de aquí? ¿Tu papá es de allá? Dicen. ¿Is your mom from here? ¿Is your dad from there? They ask. Soy de acá, de este lugar, igual que todos los demás, digo yo. I'm from here, from today, same as everyone else, I say. No, ¿de dónde eres de verdad? Insisten. No, where are you really from? They insist. Le preguntó a mi abuelo, porque él sabe todo. Y al igual que yo, tiene un aire de como que no esté aquí. I ask abuelo because he knows everything. And like me, he looks like he doesn't belong. ¿De dónde soy? Where am I from? Abuelo piensa, entrecierra sus ojos como si estuviera mirando adentro de su corazón para encontrar la respuesta. Abuelo thinks, his eyes squint like he's looking inside his heart for an answer. Tú vienes de las pampas, del campo libre y abierto, dice. You come from the pampas, the open, free land, he says. Vienes del gaucho, valiente y fuerte, del río marrón que limpia y alimenta la tierra, que nos da el grano para el pan, la leche de las vacas. You're from the gaucho, brave and strong, from the brown river that cleanses and feeds the land, that gives us the grain for our bread, the milk from the cows.
Eres de montañas tan altas que le hacen cosquillas en la panza al señor cielo, donde el cóndor anida a su familia y el jaguar me rodea en las noches. You're from mountains so high they tickle señor cielo's belly, where the condor roosts his family and the jaguar prowls at night. Pero también eres de los mares cálidos y azules que alguna vez los guerreros de bronce trataron de dominar, y que las palmeras elegantes azarician con los sus dedos. But you're also from the warm blue oceans the copper warriors tried to tame, and the elegant palm trees stretched their fingers to caress. Eres de huracanes y tormentas oscuras y de una ranita cuyo canto llama a los isleños para que vuelvan a casa cuando el sol se va a dormir. You're from the hurricanes and dark storms and a tiny singing frog that calls the island people home when the sun goes to sleep. De esta tierra donde nuestros ancestros construyeron un hogar para todos, aun estando encadenados por el color de su piel. From this land where our ancestors built a home for all, even when they were enchained because of the color of their skin. Eres de las abuelas que buscan a sus nietos y nietas, esperando, siempre esperando en una plaza, sus pañuelos blancos envolviendo el dolor de sus recuerdos. You're from the grandmothers who search for their grandchildren, waiting, always waiting in the plaza, their white handkerchiefs wrapping the sorrows of their thoughts. Vienes de la luz del sol que ilumina nuestro camino en este mundo y de la lluvia que lava y limpia nuestros errores. You come from the sunshine that lights our path in this world and the rain that washes away our mistakes. Pero abuelo, le digo, ¿de dónde soy de verdad? But abuelo, I ask, where am I really from? Abuelo se ríe. ¿Quieres un lugar? Abuelo laughs. You want a place? Why did she say that? Why do you think she says that to him? You don't know? Well, what are people asking her? Right? She asked him a question because people asked her a question. Andrea?
I think like she didn't know where she came from, but she really came from her mother of the whole time.
Oh, true. You're right. She did come from her mom.
She didn't know about it. Oh my God.
Maybe. I think she's also talking about places, right? Because a lot of people are asking her the place she's from, and he's telling her all these really awesome things, but I think other people want something specific. So she wants something specific, right? Yeah. Ella quiere algo específico. Pero todas esas tres cosas son muy bonitas y muy buenas. Señala a su corazón. Eres de aquí, de mi amor y del amor de todos que, los que existieron antes de nosotros. He points to his heart. You're from here, from my love and the love of all of those before us. De aquellos que soñaron contigo al escuchar una canción bajo la cruz del sur o al leer las palabras de un libro escrito bajo la luz de la estrella del norte. From those who dreamed of you because of a song sung under the Southern Cross or the words in a book written under the light of the North Star. Tú eres de todos nosotros. You are from all of us. Right? Not just from our moms, but from our whole families and all the people who came before us. Todas las personas que vienen antes que nosotros. Lo soy. I am. So who do we think? Maybe these are all her family, right? Su familia. Yeah. We have at the end, al fin, el sol bajando, the sun's going down, back over those mountains. The end. What did you guys think of that book? You liked it? How did it make you think of anything? Piensa en algo durante eso. What did it make you think of, Andrea?
I think of like the sunset, the beautiful sunset, and it looks so beautiful when it's sun. Mm-hmm. I've never been to the beach before.
But we can see the sunset wherever we are, right?
That wouldn't mind me.
But we can see the sunset wherever we are, right? Yeah, and it's pretty in a lot of different places, right?
Yeah, now, places. And the sun is so big, then every human can see all of the sun, even in different languages, in different countries.
That's so true. You're right. Malachi, what did it make you think of?
Well, it made me think of my family and how I never seen them in a very long time.
How did that make you feel?
Well, it made me want to see them again.
Yeah, for sure. That's so true. A lot of us haven't seen our families for a long time, right? But they're so important to who we are, right? And so hopefully we can see them again soon, right? Hopefully we'll see them soon. Yeah. Well, my friends, those are our books for today. I'm going to stop recording.